I was born and bred here, and my wife was born and bred here, went to school here, played my early football here. And do you know, when I left in 1950, that's 50, more than 50 years ago, well, I came back here in 99, so I was away almost 50 years.
Why didn't you go to play for Newcastle? Did they not want you?
Yeah. Yeah, they did. I was on amateur form, schoolboy amateur forms from Middlesbrough. Then when I was 17 and old enough to sign pro, Newcastle came after me. And for some reason, I chose Fulham.
Newcastle was your team, wasn't it?
No. My father was black and white. He bled black and white, my father.
So what did he say?
He couldn't understand me. I think I disappointed him. Times, Gary.
Yeah,
they were good times. That far away from it, from the.
Still think about that?
Never forget it. Once every day, but many times in a year, when every time we come to a big match, you know, and I'll never forget it. We're whisking away.
Does hurt me when I read it so many times that, you know, Bobby's terribly forgetful.
For my age, and I am 70, I think I have a pretty good mind. I think I'm fairly bright. And, thank you.
Bobby, I know you want to say a few words.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm absolutely delighted to be here to receive this prestigious award. It's a terrific honour. I'm totally flattered. It's a privilege. It's an honour that I respect. I'm grateful to you, and thank you very much. I was completely unaware that Sir Alex was here tonight to present this to me, so it makes the evening even more thrilling and staggering, and I'm grateful to Sir Alex for coming like he did. You know, nobody wins everything on his own. Even Tiger Woods has a caddy. And this award really is an extension, and it's an opportunity for me to say thank you very much to everybody that has supported me, that everybody that I've played with, everybody that I've managed. I've had a fabulous career. I've played with and managed some of the greatest players in the world, of that there is no doubt. I remember my Fulham days, my West Bromwich days, my England days. I remember particularly Ipswich Town, where I went as a first manager. Some of the players are here. I know that. I think Roger. Tell me, Roger, are you here? Well, Mickey Mills is here, the captain, so I had a great time at Ipswich. And, you know, and I went to Barcelona and so forth. But without the players, without the people that worked for me and that I inherited, I wouldn't be here tonight. I worked with some fantastic chairmen. I always had around me a great coaching, a great technical staff, a great medical staff, a great scouting staff. I didn't suffer fools. This is for them, of course. I'd like to thank my mother and father. My mother brought me into this world. My father brought me to football. I think my father brought me into the world as well. But he would have loved this tonight. If he'd been alive, he would have been there in the front row. He wouldn't have come by car. He wouldn't have come by train. He would have somersaulted all the way from Durham here. And I tell you this, it would have taken him about 16 and a half minutes. I'd like to thank my wife, Elsie, who stuck with me for about 52 years. I thank her for her loyalty, her support, her patience, her understanding. Without her, I wouldn't be what I am. And so it's been an absolute joy for me to have worked in association football all these years, more than 50 years, and to have met and to have played with and to have worked with all these fantastic international footballers. I would like to mention them all by name, but it would take me 17 and a half years to do it. I've got that time, but you haven't. So it just remains for me to say thank you, Gary. Thank you, Sir Alex. Thank you to the BBC for this magnificent presentation and for giving me one of the greatest evenings of my life. Thank you very much indeed.
What a lovely moment, so well deserved, Sir Bobby there.